All right. So here it is, October, 21st or so, 2013. These are the pawpaw trees you've seen before in past shows. Look them up on the archives. And you'll notice the leaves are beautiful yellow. Pawpaw being the largest native North American fruit. And I'm recommending them for everybody's backyard. They're wonderful. They don't have any parasites or diseases. So there hasn't been a frost yet, but when there is a frost, all the pawpaws on this tree ripen. And now we're going to go look at some pawpaws that happen to be here. Can I just walk over, Bill? All right. Yep, here they are. I don't know if you can zoom in on this or not. But here's a little cluster of pawpaws. I don't know. Can you see them, Bill? Oh, they came off. Okay. Yeah, here they are. You'll notice they sort of look like a bunch of bananas vaguely. And these are small ones. They make them much bigger. We're going to bring this into the show, opening up, and show you what's inside and taste them and get an opinion from our co-host as to how they taste. So that's the pawpaw story at this point, and I'm sticking to it. These are something new. They're red Holsteins. Holsteins are the usual black and white cows. These are the red Holsteins, and that you'll notice, or brown. Instead of black and white, they're red and white, or brown and white. And they're supposed to be really great milk producers. Now, you may say, well, so what? But Bill, I don't know. If you can swing over to that and take a picture of that little house, I don't know if you can, and then maybe even like zoom in a little, you will see, okay. You see it? They are open 24 hours a day. They would be open 25 hours a day if they could. And in there is all the stuff that comes out of the cows we just saw. So raw milk, raw stuff, cheeses. I don't think the cheeses are raw. In fact, we'll just take a peek inside and take a look. This is Beth and David, B.A.D Farm. A little Albany Township humor, if you will. B.A.D Farm. Here they got brown eggs from the chickens, which we'll see in a minute. Oh boy, even a little artsy work here. And now we're going into the inner sanctum of that little house. Let's just take a look. All right, here we go. Raiders of the Lost Ark. Dun, da, 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 da. Whoa, 24 hours a day. Oh boy, I'm turning the light on. Look at all this stuff. Now, oh, I hope you can get this. Here is the raw milk. And you can see there's cream. The cream is coming to the top, just like in the olden days. And this is the milk. I guess this would be the skim milk, Bill. And this would be the cream up there. So here's, get a little milk craving at 2 a.m. It's here. They have, and then if we swing around a little, there's various cheeses. One of the 7 wonders of Albany Township, Berks County. I'll read you some cheeses. Yogurt peach, yogurt plain. Oh, these are all yogurts. Crazy cranberry cheese. Here's jalapeno cheddar. Getting hungry yet? Pesto cheddar. All made right here at B.A.D Farm. We won't show you everything, so you'll have to come out here and see the real goodies. All right, let's stroll outside if we can. Right, there they are, Holsteins and brown or red Holsteins. They're having some nice feed. And if you just move your camera to the right, all that stuff that comes out of those cows right here for your gastronomic eating pleasure. Thank you. Now we're about to see Dean Rabert's garage, R-A-B-E-R-T, at the intersection of Route 143 and Hawk Mountain Road. So when you come up here, don't tell anybody about this place. It's just too wonderful. Inside you can buy, it's like a mini mart. You can buy lottery tickets, win a couple $1 million, buy a property out here. But he's the greatest mechanic in the world. The owner, Dean Rabert, is a member of the Order of the Arrow and the Boy Scouts, a service organization. And this is truly just a wonderful wonder of one of the seven wonders of Albany Township, Berks County, Bill. So you seen it? Don't tell it. Forget you saw it. This is just too nice. We don't want it to get too crowded, but boy, is it nice. Thanks. Let's read this. This is Don Meyer's funny tombstone. It says Albany Township on April 1st, get it, 1752, 100 feet north of this marker, absolutely nothing happened. Albany Township on April 1st, 1752, 100 feet north of this marker, absolutely nothing happened. Is that funny or what? This is the Kempton New Church, Swedenborg. They're Swedenborgs. Just Google if you want to, Swedenborg. Another one of the seven wonders of Albany Township. Truly amazing. It's a Christian, as you can see, and it's phenomenal. If you would Google this, you would not believe your eyes. And during October, they have this Autumn Weekends Food and Drinks, which you can, if you want to swing around, you can. And you can look at the people having the wonderful food and drinks here. They're all very healthy and nice. Swedenborg was an early 1700s philosopher, metallurgist, scientist. And he was truly a brilliant genius. And he founded this religion called the Swedenborg religion, Swedenborgen. And there's a lot of people with that religion out here in Albany Township. Obviously, they're a real asset to the township. If you just look at all the nice food they're giving everybody, it's not free. They take a little bit of money for it, but it certainly is a delicious, a nice thing out here in Albany Township. I'm going over there and get a pulled pork sandwich. Tell us about it, Brian.
Well, this is a limited signed print by Fred Wetzel. I have a certificate of authenticity signed by Lee Schistler, president of Hawk Mountain Sanctuary, and I won this at a golf tournament. Not by being a good golfer, just by being lucky. But this is a wonderful print, and all plates used for this reproduction have been destroyed. And this is number 11 of 250. So
wow.
This is a fairly decent item for the auction.
For the auction of BCTV?
I hope it gets what it's worth. I don't know what it's worth, but it should fetch $100, I think.
And of course, Lee Schistler is not the president at this time.
Oh, did not know that.
It's Jerry Reagan, which he's been on BCTV.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if you can hear that. You should be able to hear me.
Sure.
So, any parting shots for us, Brian?
Well, it's wonderful fall weather. I encourage anyone, by the time you see this, still go up to Hawk Mountain and see birds like this.
Wow.